pick up.
Hit it.
One. Action.
Tremendous.
Mickey, let me put it to you one more time, okay? The reason I put up the money for these pickup scenes is we can get a little damn skin into the thing. I mean, we even discussed it as the skinny dipping scene.
That would just be pure exploitation.
Mickey, Mickey, you don't understand. In America, exploitation is a genre.
But this has nothing to do with the idea behind Natalie or the age of diminishing expectations.
Mickey, the idea behind the picture is to get people to buy tickets. Stop using the old title and please stop fighting me every inch of the way, huh?
Okay. She takes the top off with no more compromises.
Bonnie! Lacey!
Okay, this is it. Quiet, please. Let's get rolling. No talking, no walking. Stop this. Come on. Quiet.
Hi.
Settle down.
Oh, it's so good to see you.
Missy, do me a favor. Let's just bring the last one just for protection, shall we? Bring the last one.
Let's do it. Come on. Come on, honey. Take off your top. All right. Let's go for another take. Ready? Let's take it.
42. Pick up two.
Action.
Bonnie to invite me out here. I needed a holiday. It's funny, but when we were in school back in Maryland, Bonnie was the last person I thought I would go to for peace and quiet. We had some crazy times. Thank you, yes, sir.
Bon appetit.
This is a really nice white. I picked some up last week. Remember, Mickey? Trout night?
Hmm? Oh, yeah. Right, trout night.
So how are things in Maryland? That's Kevin.
Oh, he's staying with Jake's parents. They'll spoil the tar out of him. I'm sure he'll be fat as a butterball when I get back.
So, have they caught the murderer yet? It's been 6 months already.
They'll never catch him.
They must have left some clues.
They'll never catch him because there is no murderer.
What do you mean? Your uncle? Your aunt? The priest? They were all killed, weren't they? I mean, somebody had to have done it.
The story may be difficult for you to accept, but if you want to hear it, I'll have to go way back to when I was 3 years old.
My mother had this lover who hated Willie and me. He used to tie Willie up so he wouldn't bother them. Sometimes he would even hurt him.
Sorry, I have to go through this one again, babe.
like it anymore. Come on.
What happened to your mother?
My aunt and uncle took us in. We grew up on their farm and pretty much forgot about mother. Until last year. 20 years later. We grew up on their farm and tried to forget what happened. And then we got a letter from Mother. The letter brought all those terrible memories back. I started having awful nightmares. Dear Lacey and Willie, a long time has passed, more than 20 years since I last saw you. I'm getting older and the doctor said I might not live very long. As your mother, I feel I have the right to see you at least one more time. I now live in Monroe, Georgia, and if you could just come see me.
Were you able to do anything against those nightmares?
Jake was sure it was anxiety or something. So he got me to see a psychiatrist.
Lacey, you ought to tell me all about that night when you were 3 years old. Lacey, I'm listening.
Willie and I were on the porch. Mommy told us to play outside. I'm cold. Someone's screaming. What's going on? Is that man hurting Mommy?
What man is that? What is he doing?
I don't like that man. He scares me. He ties up Willie at night and hits him. Mommy yells at me and I go to bed.
You go to sleep right away?
I'm in the kitchen now. There's a big knife. I take the knife and cut the ropes. I take the knife. I'm following down the hall. Go into Mommy's room.
And then? I'd like to ask you not to discuss Lacey's condition with the rest of the family.
Tell me, Doctor, why was she talking like that?
We were out to find out. Where is the mother now?
Well, they haven't seen each other since that night. But yesterday we got this letter from her, and I think this is what brought back all these memories.
Hmm. They live just across the river in Virginia. Is the house still there?
I don't know. I guess so. Why?
I want you to go back with her and take a look at it. You've got to convince her. She has to see the house and remember it the way it is now, not the way it was 20 years ago.
So Jake and I went back to my mother's house. The family that lived there, the parents, were on vacation, and their kids let us look around. I found the bedroom where it had happened.
I know I saw him. Are you all right?
Well, I'm awfully sorry about this. My wife isn't feeling too well.
Your husband probably didn't believe you, right?
But I was going crazy. Would you like some more wine? No, thank you.
What was that? Is there another bottle? So, what happened then?
Jake brought the shattered pieces of the mirror back to our house and put them back together like a jigsaw puzzle.
Jake, would you mind telling us what this is all about?
Wouldn't it be simpler just to get another mirror?
Well, aren't you going to answer? I'll have no more of this craziness. Now, Willie, you get out to the barn, get some turpentine, and clean up every last one of those mirrors. And the next time I see that mirror, it had better be on the trash heap.
Now, look, Lucy. What do you see? Nothing, right? Nothing but ordinary reflections. Answer me.
Yes. Nothing. Nothing but ordinary reflections.
So much for the mirror, huh?
Except there was one small piece missing.
Thank you.
I know you're there, Timmy. But you're not going to scare me. You're just wasting your time. Why don't you just stay there? I'll be back in a few hours. Or maybe I'll stay with Jeff. Oh, he's so handsome.
May I serve dessert? Would anyone care for dessert?
Lacey?
I have prepared loquats and kiwi fruit with a dash of Cointreau.
Sure.
Not for me, thanks.
Nikki?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think she's dangerous?
No, it's just like some type of nervous breakdown, I guess.
Yeah. A little therapy, some yoga, some vitamins. Bummer. Nikki?
Mm-hmm.
You asleep?
Yeah.
Oh, I feel so bad for her.
Mm-hmm.
Although, Lacey's experience would make a hell of a movie. I mean, it's all there. Girl traumatized by murders, invents ghosts to explain them.
You should write some screenplays.
But it's real. You say you want to make films about reality. Look, I am tired of living in fear, Mickey. I'm 29 years old. I want a home of my own, a secure income.
Once again,
I don't see how it could hurt her.
It's just be like exploiting her.
It's only a movie. Look, your last two films were wonderful, Mickey. They really were, but nobody saw them except a couple of UCLA film students, and they don't even pay.
Well, they were just released stupidly. The poster, the campaign, everything.
I know all the reasons, Mickey. But you're a professional movie maker. That means you do it for a living. I hate having to make excuses to the landlord and the phone company and the gas company. I feel like a beggar. Then you can make any kind of movie you want. Besides, it might be fun, like telling ghost stories around the campfire.
was that? Did something scare you, honey?
Boogeyman is here, Mommy.
There is no boogeyman, honey. You were only dreaming. Okay? Now be a good girl. Close your eyes. And don't open them again. Till the bluebird flies. I'll show you. This is an Indian arrowhead that a medicine man from the Chincoteague tribe gave me. I keep it together with the turquoise and the tears of the Indian stone in the bottom of the box, sort of grounding for the natural forces of good and evil that occur in nature. And these metals, the Saint Benedict is the most powerful against evil. You can see here on the letters on the metal, it says BRS, means Vade Retro Satana, which means get thee behind me, Satan. And this is the piece of mirror that I told you about. Only I must touch it. Only I.
So beautiful, my body. Isn't it? You know, when we first came out here after Mickey and I were married, I had no idea how it gets into your bones.
How long has it been now?
3 years. But it seems hard to believe. You know, I could just lie in the sun forever until I turn into a mummy.
I'd miss the seasons, I think. In Maryland in the spring, as if the whole world is saying good morning after a long night. In summer's lazy afternoon, with watermelon and lemonade. And autumn's standing quietly alone watching the sunset. Then it's winter again before you know it. And you're ready to climb back in again under that clean, white, fresh sheet until morning comes.
Doesn't sound like a New York winter. Manhattan snow is like a bag lady sleeping over a subway vent. Lacey? Hmm? I didn't mean to bum you out.
Oh, you didn't? Light. Sparkles off the pool. Just like the Potomac in summer. Kevin had stepped on a piece of the mirror, and it had stuck on the bottom of his shoe. Wherever the light reflected, it released the evil force.
What kind of fish are you, Mom?
Well, I know there's some white perch here.
How big are they, like a shark?
Well, maybe not that big. But you'll find out when you catch one.
Sorry, I didn't mean to roll in the water. I'll get you a towel.
Here, why don't you take the box back to the car?
Freezing!
so long.
It looks like he's just sitting there waiting.
Waiting for what?
We don't have boogeymen. We only have goblins.
Goblins and boogeymen all come from the same make-believe world.
A goblin frightens naughty children.
What are you reading?
Oh, it's Hollywood Babylon. It's about the good old days when Hollywood destroyed real people instead of toys.
Joseph looks like he comes from that world.
Yeah, he actually does. Joseph worked for one of Von Stroheim's stars, who lived in a mansion just above us in the hills. When she died, he had no place to go. Bonnie found him walking down the hill.
What's happening tonight?
Oh, a small party in your honor. Just a few friends, agents, producers, actors.
Low-budget Hollywood types. They're looking forward to meeting you.
I don't know, maybe he found a better home at the bottom of the hill.
He's gone?
Yeah.
I don't believe it. Look at all these people. How am I supposed to keep all these people happy? Mickey, this is so typical of you. You give a party and I end up doing all the work.
Funny, this was your idea, you know. I really hate parties, you know that.
Everybody, I'd like you to meet my dear friend Lacey, who's visiting with us from the historic Potomac shore of Maryland.
This is Jim and Priscilla. Jim's in distribution.
Looking forward to an evening of thrills at the Lombards.
I'm charmed to meet you, Lacey. Maryland's such a lovely state. Hi.
And this is Constance. And, Sandor?
This one's Sandor, that's right.
It's a great pleasure to meet you, Lacey. I admire beauty and adventure.
Hello. By the by, Sandor just looks too young for me, actually. He eats well and gets plenty of sleep.
And coffee, and
hi, I'm Kathy. Hope we can share something real.
Good meeting you, Lacey. Looking forward to hearing your story.
Why?
I'm Sally's friend, Cynthia.
I'm not married either. How do you do?
So you're the demon killer herself, huh? I'm Bernie, Mickey's friend. This is Sally. She had the distinction of being Miss Arizona in 1979. Very good year indeed.
Mickey's been unusually mysterious about you, Lacey.
Now, I know Constance will be fascinated by your story, Lacey.
Yes, I'm what you call nosy.
Lacey, why don't you tell them about what happened in the barn?
It was a piece of fur, and it had its own power. Lacey, what are you doing?
I'm fixing supper, dear.
Lacey, Ernest and Helen are dead.
Oh, that makes dinner for four. Father, Molly, you're staying, aren't you? Would you be a doll and fix me a drink?
Thank you.
Don't tell me any more, honey. I'll have nightmares for weeks.
Wild tails, kiddo. Great stud. Boo!
I just think you're so strong and brave and everything. Well, if I thought I was going to get killed, I'd just die.
Let me know when they take you on a UFO. Got a great eye for detail.
I really envy your experience. Are you famous back home?
I could help you feel better. Do you like jazz?
Were you on the television news when it happened?
Could I hear that bit about the kids on the beach again? I love that part.
I'd love to study you. You're just an incredible phenomenon.
They really like you, Lacey. You're a hit.
My God, you poor thing. You've had a heck of a time. Ghost in the mirror. Stack of bodies. The whole thing gives me a chill just thinking about it.
Come on, Connie, baby. A faint stomach can get you where you are today.
Hi, kid.
You'll be all right, won't you? Yeah. I'm fine.
Fine? Are you kidding? You're terrific. Making this girl and her story fantastic. It's a gift from heaven. This is the movie I want you to make. All right, look, just get everything she says on tape, get exactly the way she says it, and I swear I'll raise a half a mil by noon tomorrow.
I don't know whether I want to do another movie right now. I first want to see how Natalie or The Age of Diminishing Expectations does.
Do me a favor, all right? It's not Natalie and The Age of Diminishing Expectations. Just don't call it that anymore, okay?
I hate the new title.
What's in a name if it smells sweeter at the box office? Look, Mickey, if you don't do this film, someone else will, because it's now. I mean, the public doesn't want the psychos and the slashers. I mean, Halloween and stuff like that is old hat. What they want now is suspense and melodrama. I mean, they want mysterious forces that move and poltergeists. This crack mirror gimmick is perfect. Just trust me. I mean, together you and me will make a smash hit. I swear it'll make you in this town.
If you decide to make a horror film, you'll make your own kind of horror film. I'm not being very helpful, am I, Mickey?
No.
Let me put in my 10% worth. Brian De Palma spent $18 million on that bomb of his, Blowout. You could make 50 movies for that.
You like summer wine?
No, thanks, dear. I'm fading. And it seems to happen earlier and earlier all the time.
You're not going to go home.
Well, to tell you the truth, all this blood and gut stuff makes me vaguely uneasy. The Lacey girl, all that business. I can't even see those movies. They scare me to death. I better find Sandra.
I'll have Joseph find his home. Bonnie?
Where's Joseph?
Still no sign of him.
Well, maybe I'll drop you and we'll talk on the way.
Well, is it all right, Bonnie? I hate to be a pet.
Constance, I think you're going.
Very nice to have met you, dear. I hope everything works well for you.
I think your story is just fascinating. I'm an actress, you know. I was voted most talented and also chosen Miss Arizona herself. Myself, I mean. You're Bernie's friend, aren't you?
Bernie is a very good person to know.
He's taken an interest in my career.
He is very high on the project.
Isn't that great, Lacey?
It's really not something to... It's not right.
Oh, no, the part of you would be a wonderful role.
Maybe it's better to leave it alone.
Lacey, they're practically killing each other to get on the bandwagon. What you experienced must have been... terribly exciting. Growing up in Arizona is wonderful, of course. But after you've seen the Grand Canyon, then what?
Maybe you're better off forgetting this whole thing. Forget you ever met me. Just go back to Arizona.
Lacey's sorry. She had a long flight yesterday.
I'm
I'm sure she didn't mean it. That's all right. Well, I promised to keep poor Sandor company. Please tell Mr. Lombard what a pleasure it was to meet him and how much I enjoyed meeting him. Shall we rejoin the party?
I'd really rather lie down for a bit.
Come on, Lacey, don't be a hermit.
I shouldn't have told you and Mickey about all of this. Gotten you involved.
But what are friends for?
It's just this idea of making a movie. You can't toy with something like that.
Lacey, nobody's toying with it or with you. I love you. I'd do anything in the world for you.
I've done some stunt work, too.
Isn't that dangerous? You must do pretty well.
I do okay.
Do you know Mr. Lombard?
Yeah, he wanted to use me in his last picture.
You didn't do it? Holy cow, I'd give anything for...
I'm up for this part. It's a combination Star Wars and Smokey and the Bandit. He's a bootlegger and out of space.
Have you ever worked with Burt Reynolds?
Sure.
Oh, he was my inspiration to become an actress.
Really? Would you like to meet him? But I get to know you.
Still Miss Flagstaff, I saw him in a restaurant.
No more talking now. Let's just pretend we're making a silent movie. Thank you.
So, here you are. To success.
Success.
You know, this project of Mickey's is a perfect vehicle for you. You can do crazy.
Personally, I've never been insane, but sure, I can relate to it.
Well, looks you certainly have. Frankly, otherwise, you wouldn't be at this party. What'd you say your agent was again? Get a little privacy here.
Well, sort of between agents right now, but I'm developing a relationship at William Morris.
Forget it. You know, I can get you in this picture.
You think so?
I know so. You have the potential to be a goddamned Annette of the 80s. You know, a little sweet, a little bad, a little sad.
I feel it's possible. I'm putting it out. Good to know that people who can are picking up on it.
Yeah, I mean, who can miss that quality you've got? Listen, some friends of mine brought back this primo stuff from Colombia. Since we're in the powder room, what do you say?
It makes my nose numb.
You know, who needs to feel their nose?
I took the liberty of making a few phone calls. Just on Mickey's name and a material, I've already got 250 thou committed.
That's great, Bernie.
I wish Mickey was here. When the hell's he getting back?
Well, Constance lives in Malibu. He's been out there.
I'm doing something with this I never do. I'm kicking another 50 thou myself.
So you're going for it?
Going for it? I see 9 or 10 million gross, domestic. Hey, what do you say we give the little lady a point?
What's a point?
That's cute. Why don't you tell her?
A percentage. 1% of the profits.
More specifically, in this case, $100,000.
No one's going to make a movie about my mirror.
Come on. Everyone backs a winner. Why don't you be the technical advisor? You move out here. Everybody loves it out here. Go to the beach, check out the mountains. Pretty soon you'll be a native.
All the culture you can take, the Hollywood Bowl, the Universal Tour. You'll even get to like the smog.
I can see I'm wasting my time here. You want to talk some sense into her, Bonnie, okay?
I'll try. Maybe Sally left.
Let's see if the car's gone.
I didn't think she'd go without me.
I'll give you a ride. See, Mickey used her in his last movie. Love you, huh? We'll have lunch.
I thought it was real.
She used to be, but, Hollywood hardened her.
Have you made a lot of movies?
It's been my 12th, but, I'm thinking of skipping my 13th.
Do you usually work with, Mickey?
No, just on this latest one.
Oh, and Natalie, or The Age of Diminishing Expectations?
That was the original title, but see, we saw the previews in Des Moines, and we decided to change it to Kiss and Tell. You like it?
It's easier to remember.
Right. I also convinced him to, you know, put a little sex in. So we went back, we did some pickups. Hey, it's so hard with these European artsy-fartsy directors to get that last ounce of punch.
How did you get to know Sir Gray?
That's Lord Gray, honey.
Oh, lordy, lordy, lordy.
Anyway, I do him a favor now and then, you know, sort of when he's in a jam. I like helping people. You know, the big people and the little people.
That's really very nice.
Hey, to me, people are people are people.
Oh, I absolutely agree. I mean, without people, there wouldn't be anybody.
That's funny. Anyway, do you sing and dance?
I'm studying.
Good, because I'm thinking maybe this crack mirror thing is a musical. Thinking of trading in my Mercedes on one of these, you know, one of these diesels.
They're very economical.
Hey, they're the wave of the future. Small on the outside, big on the inside. Hey, did you open the garage door?
No.
Ah, those things are always going haywire. You're very talented, girl.
Thank you.
I was thinking of getting Mickey to use your friend in this horror film. You know, using the Miss Arizona publicity angle.
That would be really very nice for her.
Yeah, but see, the more I talk to you, I see a certain innocent, vulnerable quality. It would be just perfect for the role of Lacey.
Really?
Yeah, that's it, what you just did.
What did I do?
Doesn't matter. Just close your eyes.
Dear, I know just how you feel. As I was telling my husband, Jim, we used to have all sorts of weird things coming out of the swamps. You know, eerie lights and creepy noises and things. Well, it's enough to send you just running right under the bed. Anyway, when I grew up, I knew that it was just gas bubbles. I mean, but when you're a dumb kid out in the middle of nowhere, well, you just have to make up your own excitement.
Lacey didn't make it up.
Oh, of course she didn't. I think it's just terrible, too. You know, the way everybody's been oohing and aahing over you. Though, Lord knows, I mean, you can understand how some people will take on when they see the chance to make a buck.
Not that it's on anyone's mind all the time, necessarily.
The city can be exhausting.
Tell me about it. Like I told Jim, nobody cares about true values anymore. like art, life, such. Now, if I was to play you in this film, I would have to know every little thing about you.
Priscilla, my sweet. Some guy was hogging the bathroom and I had to use the bushes.
Look, how are you going to close a deal for me? You can't even close your fly.
Thousand apologies. I was anxious to return to you.
Now, it was one of our solemn marriage vows taken in front of God and everybody that you would get me a big part in a movie before the first year of our wedding anniversary.
Patience, fair lady. The cuckoo sings at dawn, and there are movies anon. Author! Author!
I want some results. You should be out there working and working and working on these people.
What people? You've been blinded by that haze of sobriety that surrounds you.
Bernie is still out there, you ding-dong.
Seems to me, if I may interrupt your catalog of grievances.
Seems to me that if you don't get it together, I am going to be taking a taxicab straight to divorce court. Look, Jim, I mean, I'm just perfect for this part. I can scream and carry on to beat the band. Cream and sugar in your coffee? Jim? Jimmy? Have some coffee with me, Lacey.
Why is it so dark?
I really don't need any coffee, Bonnie. Come on, it'll pep you up.
What the hell happened to the lights?
I can't see anything. Where is everybody?
Oh, here.
Hold on to my hand.
Watch your step. I suppose the fuse blew.
Copper gas stoves.
Why is the fridge open?
Where is everybody?
Mirror.
Bernie, I'm glad you haven't lost the touch, but we'll start casting later, okay?
Sofa for a couple of hours just to find my wife here and then I'll have work.
Since I knew the secret of the evil force that inhabits the mirror, I was immune to it. But it used Joseph and possessed him to seek revenge against those who wanted to exploit it, who believed that my story was just fun and games.
I'll just be a couple of minutes, Bonnie. I feel I should see Joseph's grave just one more time.
Well, I'm staying here. It's got nothing to do with me. It's unbearable. I can't take this anymore.
They want me to do the movie more than ever.
How do you feel about it? Are you gonna do it?
It's funny. But they think it'll help us forget.
Help me with the top, please. I already broke a nail. Mickey?
Mickey?